For Java interview question and answer. In this video tutorial, we are going to learn about one of the very important Java concurrency interview question. And question is here: what properties does each Java thread have? So to understand answer of this question, let's go through the first of all concept, and then we'll see an example. Yeah, so each Java thread has the following five properties. Let's try to understand each and every property. So first property, an identifier of type long, that is a unique number basically within the JVM. Second property, name, main name. So every thread has a name, and that is a type of a string. Now priority, which is a type of basically integer. Now fourth property is every thread has its own state at the at the given point of time, right? Now fifth property, a group, right? Every thread belongs to the particular thread group, and every group has a name, right? So every thread belongs to the certain group. Why we basically Java provided a group? Basically, if you add more than one thread in a group, then you can control that thread as a group, right? So you can either all the threads within that group you can interrupt, or you can take any kind of action, right? And that's what we have a thread group. Let's try to understand these things through an example. Yeah, so here is the example which I have already created offline just to save some time. So here you can see I haven't created any explicitly any Java thread, but here basically at least in your application, at least you have one thread, and that is called main thread, right? From where your program execution starts. So how we can get the reference of the current thread? So in thread class basically we have a method is called current thread, right? So it's a static method, so directly you can call by the thread dot current thread, and we get the reference of current thread. Yeah, after that, once you get the reference of current thread, then here we can get the ID, thread name, priority, is its state, and thread group name. So here everything subsequently I have printed over here. Here you can see, right? So thread ID, name, priority, thread state, and group. Right, so if you run this application, then you'll get output something like this, right? So here you can see the thread ID as a long number, then thread name, it's a main thread, thread priority, by default thread priority is a 5, but you can change, we have a set priority method, so using that you can change the priority of the thread. We have a state, so currently printing as a running runnable state. And finally, this thread, main thread, belongs to the group name is called main itself, right? So if you create any thread, your custom thread, right, using using a thread class or running a runnable interface, right, or in other ways, then easily you can retrieve this information, right? So that's all I have in this video tutorial. I hope you enjoy learning this video. If you really like this video, then hit on the like button. If you did not subscribe KK Java tutorials till yet, then please go ahead and subscribe it. And if you want to learn Java in much more detail, then you can refer our website kkjavatutorials.com. Guys, big thank you, and see you there in the next video tutorial.